intern in ARTC last semester. So I would like to thank this opportunity to do a presentation here, and I would like to share my growth project during my internship. So the purpose of this presentation is to show you a very simple how to implement a simple growth project. Today in some companies, especially in the aerospace industries, they would like to use a masking tape to stick on the hundreds of components. This actually is quite waste time, manpower, and it's not really efficient. So if we can use the robot to do the mask to do the automated masking process, it will save a lot of manpower and a lot of money, especially for some small companies. It will be more affordable. So this is actually the intention to do this project. So using the ROS, I implement the Cartesian Motion Planner using ROS for masking tasks on Cobol UR10. There are two methods I used. The first one is Cartesian plugging, and the second one is Descartes. Besides, I also implement here actually known ROS-based algorithm for enabling communication between UR robot and the external peripherals. So this is actually my project development. First of all, using the ROS, we need to create a URDF. URDF stands for Universal Robotic Description Format. This actually is the UR10 URDF. As you can see from here, this is just a sample code of URDF, and it's an XML format. So this is the joint. This sample is showing you the shoulder pan joint. Its parent link is base link, and its child link is the shoulder link, which show you the visual features and some other information like inertia, this information. So to simulate the real working environment in ARTC, a table was created. And we can see from here that the UR10 robot is actually on this table. And then this is the PO tool, which is used to dispense the liquid to perform the masking task. This is the PO tool URDF. So next, we need to load the URDF into the Moving Setup Assistant. Moving Setup Assistant is actually to generate some configuration files and launch files. So this is some pages of the Moving Setup Assistant. As you can see from here, we need to set up the virtual joint. We also need to set up the landing groups, which is to tell the ROS that it has different parts of the robot. And we can also see from here that you have the end effector and robot pose. Robot pose is to set a fixed pose of, for example, the home position of the robot. When I was doing the project, I sometimes feel that the robot will move in the, because all the joints will move in the omnidirection. So sometimes the joint pose will be quite dangerous and it is unsafe. Especially we have the table and work cell. Sometimes the robot will collide with the table or work cell. It's quite unsafe and dangerous. So I decided to set the joint limit. This is how I set the joint limit in the URDF. But for this one, actually, we can see from here that it is from minus pi to positive pi. As we know that all the joints can move in omni direction, so it's 360 degrees. So, but this one is written in the radius unit. So as we can see from here that we set some, for example, the shoulder lift lower limit. It's from minus 1.5, it's almost like minus half pi to zero. This, and then you can avoid some unnecessary pose. For example, this one, the robot, it is unnecessary to move in this pose. It's more likely to move in this pose. So it's like this one. So next is a Cartesian plugin implementation. Cartesian plugin is a user-friendly path planner for the movement. It simultaneously interacts with the Qt widget and the update environment. It defines and assigns Cartesian waypoints, which can be passed to the Cartesian planner of the movie package, and can be executed on the bonus simulator and the real robot. This widget, and we can add a new waypoint and then to remove it anytime. And then we also can use the interaction marker to set the waypoints. So in this project, we want to use the robot to just write the ARTC letters. So it's like the right side, this one. But as we can see, some of them are the linear motion, but some of them is more like a trajectory point. So if we use interaction marker to do the trajectory point, it will be more like, it's not easy to do because we have a lot of different points. It's not easy to just use interaction marker to set one by one. So we use the path creator to get all the coordinates that we want. And then I use the Excel to get all the coordinates and format it to the YAML file. And then YAML file is loading into the Cartesian path planner, and then we can execute Cartesian path. So this is this widget. We also can change its step size, which is to change the speed. So this is actually the demonstration of the Cartesian plugin that I use to describe ARTC. Since the Pico tool is quite expensive, so I use the marker to use that. So the next method I would like to introduce is Descartes. So for Descartes, it requires the software developer to implement three things. The first one is the robot model, which will solve the forward and inverse kinematics. The second one is the trajectory point, which is to define what the path looks like. And the third one is the planner, to find a valid route along the trajectory using the provided model of the robot. So because I have used the path creator to get all the coordinates. So, for the linear motion, it will be quite easy to write this equation. But for some trajectory points, I use the Excel to get a polynomial equation. This one is so I don't need to write my equation myself. So this is actually my equation. So for the top one, top two is A is. To write the letter A. Letter A is like this one. So the first one is in this way. So it's the linear motion. So the C is the trajectory. Is a curve line. So I use the polynomial equation that I get just now. But we can also use the math equation to do that. So after we have some, and then we now in execute. So we have a lot of different joint solutions to get specific one point. So for example, the robot can move in this point, and then it can have a lot of different joint solutions. So this one is to show you that they found a different joint solution out of 10 iterations. But actually the robot can just, so this one is still, Descartes help us to find the lowest cost function, which is to get the best curve, best path, that is the most smooth path to write the ARTC letters. So this is actually we can see from here, is the lowest cost is 5.8, it's quite small. So this is the user Descartes to write the ARTC, but because my internship, I do not have time already, so this one is just a simulator. So it's actually quite similar to the previous one, Cartesian plugin, but ARTC. So next, I would like to introduce the I/O control using row serial. Actually, they just now introduced about this one already. But for my for my project. So rows I/O control is used to simulate that the rows can control the two center point, the TCP. So for this one, the publish and subscribe communication mechanism was created. So use the USB communication. So for PIS, so the PIS-C published a message. This one is to publish a message in the toggle LED. So by the subscriber, our subscriber, this one used is Arduino. So Arduino subscribe to the message, and then to define the output voltage, and then the solid state relay will be activated, and then solid state relay is an electronic switching device to on or off the lamp. So the lamp is used to simulate the PCP for this one. So this one is the sample that I write in the Arduino. So we need to set up the subscriber first, and then publish the message, and then subscribe, and the subscriber to subscribe the message. So this is use the root serial to simulate this one. So PC publish a message, and then we can see from here. Actually, as you can see from here, like the LED actually on, turn on or off. This one. After that, we know that the ROS, the PCB can be controlled by the ROS serial, and then we know that this project is the to perform the masking task and use the Pico tool. But for Pico tool, sometimes we don't need, it's unnecessary to on all the time. So sometimes you need to off. So for this one, I get the TCP coordinates first, and then compare the TCP coordinates, and then compare with my desired TCP coordinates, which is to define the on or off the the Pico tool. So when we compare it, and then it will publish a message to on or off the Pico tool. So this is the how I write the code of this part. Besides to use the coordinates, we can also use the robot join post. So these are two methods that we can use. So if you're interested in ROS, you can join this event.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Yeah. So the floor is open for anyone who want to do lightning talk. But to get it started.